o da umma Muhammed sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem. The ummah of the great messenger whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected, favored to receive the revelation of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in similar days, 14 centuries ago. How blessed, how great is the day, Al-Jum'ah, the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept as a favor only to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not for any ummah before them. The day is al-jum'ah, khayru yawmin tala'at alayhi ash-shams, the best day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the sun to, the best day in the best month, the month of Ramadan. Out of the months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set. In the last 10 days in the month of Ramadan, the best 10 days throughout the whole year for every individual in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In one of the odd nights, hopefully it will be the best out of the best, out of the best, out of the best. خَيْرٌ مِنْ خَيْرٌ مِنْ خَيْرٌ مِنْ خَيْرٌ مِنْ خَيْرٌ. Jum'ah, Ramadan, last 10 days, the odd nights of the 10 days. In a similar day, you and me have received the responsibility from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the first verses of the Quran in the cave of Hira, at that very amazing, significant, outstanding meeting between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa aminu wahi as-sama', the angel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed and assigned by bringing, revealing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messages to each one of the prophets, Jibreel alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is given Muhammad and his ummah. We need to keep understanding and reflecting upon the same meaning. Brothers and sisters, there is no guidelines will come after the book of Allah. And there is no messenger will be coming after Muhammad. The previous nations, when they went astray, when they are messed up, when they are absolutely, completely corrupted, they were always waiting for the new message and the new messenger to come and set up the new guidelines to bring the corruption back closer to Allah. Under La ilaha illallah, under there is no God but Allah, with every messenger. And that's not applied on the ummah of Muhammad. We are not waiting for no one. We are the ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sealed with us, the whole chain. It's not just a name. There is no amana could be heavier than the amana of the message that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did receive. The Sahaba did understand it very well. I need you to understand, we have been waiting for whom to reconciliate the situation? We have been waiting for whom? Al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Al-Mahdi, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send, he is still one of me and you. A follower from the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He just a man who did understand the responsibility of this amana, which every one of us should be the same. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take him further just to take the lead at certain time before the resurrection, with signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be sending, and so on and so forth. But you and me is the real inheritor. We have been waiting for what? Summits. We have been waiting for conferences. We have been waiting for conventions. We have been waiting for what? To fix your and my and our situation. We have been blessed by the great month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the month of Ramadan. And it's a matter of hours, and the month will be gone. In the same day, or similar days, 14 centuries ago, you and my Prophet, may the blessing and the peace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him, did receive. Iqra. Read. You will find in the Quran the two chapters after one another, 96, 97. Al-Alaq and Al-Qadr. In the same night, in the same night, you and me have been selected, not burdened. ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى. Quran has never been revealed to be a burden or to give you hard time. إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى. It's only a reminder for those who want to get closer to Allah and they want to finish their life if they understand what the purpose of this life. I need you to write down what's the ghaya and what's the wasila. What's the purpose? And what did the mean? What did the tool? We have been dealing with Ramadan and others as ghaya. Mecca is a ghaya. Umrah is a ghaya. Al-Hajj is a ghaya. And that's absolutely wrong. Every act of worship, giving a piece of bread to an orphan, I can tell you this, can save you from the hellfire and put you in Jannah. More than 30 years of attending Ramadans. If Allah will accept that particular righteous deed and Allah will see in your heart sincerity that was not there when you spend the whole night praying and the whole morning stopping yourself from eating, drinking and dealing with your wives. اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. Few verses has changed the whole future of the whole horizon and universe to tell every human being the last message is coming. And here is the man and his ummah will be responsible of this amana to take it till the day of judgment. And no one else will be coming to handle it except you. Do we really understand it? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealing after the same chapter of Al-Alaq the significance of the night of power. I have been trying to focus on that particular meaning because that is the night that everyone has been waiting for. And I'm telling you, the whole month is gone. The whole year will be gone. The whole life will be gone. The whole life will be gone. Ramadan will be going. That's true. The month of mercy will be gone. That's true. The month of forgiveness will be gone. That's true. The month of next being freed from the hellfire will be gone. That's true. But where is the meaning of it? What is the meaning of it? Are we dealing with Ramadan, with the night of power, with the time, with the location? Or we are establishing a relationship with Allah? That you will be in your office sincere in your work. And Allah's gonna look at you without being deviated from your way with Allah. We don't wanna be in the two extremes. Oh, brother, don't worry about prayer. My heart is good. I'm taking care of families and I'm taking care of others and I'm so kind and I'm so, great. Then what? And the other one is saying, I'm absolutely in the masjid 24/7. and on the other side he's a thief, backbiting, bad words, ugly tongues, rude tongues, and so on and so forth. Neither nor is our deen. Neither nor is our deen. Our deen has means to reach your destination. The acts of worship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the machine that He has created better than anyone else. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Doesn't he know exactly the secret, the password, the sensors, the depth of whole manual of what He has created? Yes. And He told us, this will take you to be closer to Me, which is the acts of worship. So no one can come and say, I can be closer to Allah without prayer. I can be closer to Allah without hijab. I can be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without the Quran. I can be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it has nothing to do with the financial transactions. I can be closer to Allah along with dealing with riba, yujri. And He has, my heart is good. I have never cheated. That's true. I have never been a liar. That's true. But that's not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted you to be of those morals, to get closer to Allah, to listen to His commands. So Allah will differentiate between those who are listening and obeying and those who are listening and disobeying. It is that simple. Everything will be gone. When we say Ramadan has gone, the real word that we are gone. We. Every day is going, a part of you is gone. Can anyone deny this? It's a certain time, 14 years, 15 years, 60 years, 100 years, plus few minutes, plus few seconds. And when a day is gone, a part of you is gone. Ramadan will come back to those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have them to meet again with Ramadan. But whomever has gone in reality is us. When we say ذهب رمضان or رحل رمضان, Ramadan has left, the reality that we, a part of us has left. And I'm trying to keep making that example to understand, it's the same amount of water in the same cup. And it's an irreversible process. Whatever water will come out of that cup will never come back. Every second, every minute, every day, every week, every month, every year will come out of this cup, will never come back. You will beg one day to come back for 1 second, brothers. 1 second, you will ask Allah to bring you back. Ya Allah, now I understand the reality. Let me come back and say one good word. One. قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. Allah is saying, just one. You will say, Ya Allah, bring me back to do one righteous deed. One. How many we are missing? How many we are doing with no value? فَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. You have been building, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, you might come in the day of judgment, apparently, people might see you of virtues like Jibal Tuhama, like the mountains of Tuhama, some mountains in Mecca. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to this, all of these deeds, because they have no value, no sincerity, no base, no core, no foundation. And Allah will say, all are gone. All are gone. You spend the night. You did fast the morning. But you were Ramadanese, not Rabbanese. This terminology, it's a Franco-Arab terminology, but it's given us what we are looking for. Decide today as a major obligation at furrowing Ramadan. You are furrowing the month of mercy. You are furrowing the month of generosity. You are furrowing the month of being freed from the hellfire. But you missed the whole point that the most generous will never die, will never disappear. The most merciful will never die, will never disappear. The one who has the keys of Jannah, paradise and hellfire is Allah. حَيٌّ قَيُّومٌ لَا تَأْخُذُهُ سِنَةٌ وَلَا نَوْمٌ. He's the ever eternal living will never die, will never sleep, will never be unmindful, will never forget. ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Nothing is similar to him, and he is the all-seer or hearer. Decide before leaving. Sisters, brothers, 26 days, alhamdulillah, we ask Allah to be amongst those who did pray, did fast, did act, did give, did donate to the sake of Allah. Sincerity, we ask Allah to be amongst them. We ask Allah to be amongst those whom Allah will accept in that great month of Ramadan. Yes, we ask Allah to be amongst those whom Allah will give them the favor of the night of power. Not because of the time or the place. It's because of the connection and relationship you established with Allah. Ya Allah, maybe I'm not that VIP person. Maybe I'm not that strong. Maybe I'm not that competent. Maybe I'm not that high position guy. But wallahi, ya Allah, my heart is whatever pleases you, I'll be there for. It's that simple. It's that simple. When you are in your office and you say, I'm here working, but I'm fearing Allah. You are playing soccer as a part of halal entertainment, but you are still saying, I am entertaining but fearing Allah. I am a lawyer but fearing Allah. I am an engineer but fearing Allah. I am a physician but fearing Allah. The whole ummah has been messed up. When we separated the dunya, deen will not bring me dunya. Who said so? Who said that deen will not make you the happiest as a husband, as a wife, as a father, as a son, as a leader, as an employee, as an employer, as a president, as a minister? Without deen, you have zero, null. Where is Qarun? Where is Pharaoh? Where is Haman? Where are the soldiers? Where is the people of Ad? Where is the people of Thamud? Gone. Gone. We have been trying. Our deen is the ideal curriculum. Not because we are Muslims, because it's Allah's deen. It's coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows what He has created and what's good for them. You buy a GMC washing machine. When you try to fix the best, you say, I take it to the supplier, to the manufacturer, who knows every piece in it very well. Why you are not understanding that's exactly the same for Allah? Why the sister is still bargaining about the hijab? Why the brothers are still bargaining about the salah? Why the brothers are still bargaining about the zakah? Why the brothers and the sisters and the communities are still bargaining about Allah's rules? Oh, let me, this is okay and this is not. This is makes sense and this is doesn't. We have reached the level we talk about our deen. We use our sense. We are human being with very limited capability. We cannot stop whatever bad is in our stomach and intestine or deal with it. And without Allah's mercy, it will never come out. You cannot make that dirt of a good smell. It will remain the same. We are that weak, and we are judging Allah's deen and curriculum. We say we don't understand and we need to understand more. Yes, Sahaba used to ask for elaboration. We have in the Quran the dialogue between the Sahaba and the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to understand, to learn, not to bargain and dispute with Allah. Those who have disputed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَوَكُلَّمَا جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ بِمَا لَا تَهْوَى أَنفُسُكُمْ فَرِيقًا كَذَّبْتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. The Ummah of Muhammad can never kill prophets or deny them. We have weakness, yes. And that is the reason the weakness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can supersede it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can strengthen it through the relationship with Allah. Through having Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most powerful in your life. That is the reason the Sahaba, when everyone tried to come against them, and they were minority. إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ. Everyone is coming against you. Buddhists, Hindus, communism, this, that. What they said? Only one statement. They said, if that is the case, everyone is in the hand of Allah. Whomever the anti, the Islamophobia is getting, is increasing, is getting strengthened in a way or another, which will never stop. Our iman in Allah should get more, because we know that there is no exit, there is no refuge, there is no success will come from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم لا ملجأ منك إلا إليك. We cannot go from you to other than you. We cannot go from you to other than you. Let's try to make sure that we are summarized and very particular in what we need to live with. 2 weeks ago we were talking about the changes. The situation of the Ummah will change. We left the masjid in confirming that situation will be changing when we change. And that was the second Ramadan, the second week, second Jum'ah in Ramadan. It's the fourth. Can you go through the transaction? What you can say before and after? We have in management and just like protocols and processes and before and after. You go to just like, even those who are promoting the gain loss, the weight loss products, and oh, before and after. Oh, what's happening? That guy lost 200 pounds in a week. Sometimes it's just, can we do before and after? And that's exactly what the Sahaba of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did. And that was exactly what we learned from them. You came to the Salah before and after. You are gonna sit in a session that will increase your knowledge before and after. If there is nothing there, it's really nothing there. It's always nothing there. There is nothing in the book. You came inside the Salah. Your tongue is used to, just like maybe culture, your tongue is a little aggressive in a way or another, even without meaning it. Then you came to pray Jum'ah, or you came to pray Dhuhr, or you came to pray Asr, before and after. If you didn't leave the masjid and you feel that your tongue has got a little ABS, anti-brake system, a little absorber, it might be little, but that means you are there. That means you are there. You were not maintaining the five prayers. You were missing the five. Then you have become missing one, till you will become missing zero. Nothing will happen in a day. Nothing will happen between a blinking of an eye. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a process. You charge the battery, then you start your car, start your heart, then you move on. It doesn't happen as a magic. Decide today, or make it before and after. And we will make exactly the same the first day after Ramadan. The first month after Ramadan. We have proven to one another that I can stop smoking cigarette for 16 hours. We have proven to one another that I can stay longer standing for prayer with no issues. We have proven to one another that I can hold the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with love give myself a commitment to read a whole juz, or less or more. We have proved to one another that I can give money. I can sacrifice to the sake of Allah. Is it to the sake of Ramadan or to the sake of Allah? We have already no excuse. We don't have it. We have proved that we can fast, so we can do the optional fasting later on. We have proved that our eyes have been stopped to look at haram, so we can easily do the same after Ramadan. We can pray instead of the 8 rak'ahs or the 20 or the 23 or the 11. I can make 2 rak'ahs at night every day before Fajr. We have proved that we can wake up before. No, man, it's flipping my whole system upside down and I cannot wake up that early. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making in that prayer, indicating that as-salatu khayrun min an-nawm, prayer is better than sleeping. Because Allah wanna test you. Do you really know that prayer is better than sleeping or not? You need to decide. No, no, ya Allah, sleeping is better than prayer. Okay, that's your decision. We have given an evidence against us that we can. We can feel of those who are starving, hungry, thirsty. We felt. We have proved to ourselves that we can do stuff that typically we cannot. Because of the intention and the persistency, consistency and the gut. All what you need to do before leaving, was it for Ramadan or for Allah? Ramadanese or Rabbanese? And based on the answer, I can tell you from now, I can give you the example of before and after for the Ramadanese and the before and after for the Rabbanese. You want to know the difference? Check the number of prayers tomorrow morning in the Fajr prayer or the Fajr prayer in the last few days of Ramadan, and check the number of prayers in the Fajr prayer of starting the second day of Shawwal. You will understand what's meant by before and after. You will understand. Rabbanis, not Ramadanis. Number two, to make it quickly, inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Aisha radiallahu anha, everyone knows just, it's one dua that, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told Aisha about one particular dua. We have been making in kunut too many, mashallah. May Allah accept all of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are deserving to be accepted for all of them, inshallah. But we know from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his teaching to Aisha, ya Rasulullah, if I'll be able to catch the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the night of power, I'll be attending Ramadan, what I'm supposed to make as dua? The Prophet never gave her a book or two, three pages. He gave her one statement. Listen to this. He told her, Aisha, just say, when you are just, you know what's the night of power? Or the minute of being accepted in the night of power, that is the top of the top of the top of the top of any minute in your whole life. And the one who is given the answer is the main doctor, the Prophet. So he's giving you the prescription that no one can give except him. And it was not that long. He gave her one statement. Ya Aisha, just when you will be able to catch it, say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. Five words. Ya Allah, you are the pardoner. Ya Allah, you are the forgiver. Please pardon me. Forgive me. That's it. Oh, really? Yes. Al-afu. Why the Prophet didn't tell her, ask for Jannah, ask to be away from the hellfire, ask her to get the best out of the best in dunya, ask her to be with me. Just one statement. The Prophet's telling her, if you will catch the most valuable minute in your life, focus on that one statement. Ya Allah, you are the pardoner, the forgiver who loves pardon and forgiveness. Pardon me and forgive me. Why afu? Why that particular attribute? There are too many. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam can give as an advice. Why in that very particular outstanding and significant moment? The Prophet is telling us, focus on this. And he's given this to his most beloved, As-Siddiqa, the most knowledgeable amongst every woman from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, As-Siddiqa bint As-Siddiq. When you fast, when you pray, when you act, and apparently or internally get closer to Allah, listen to that particular meaning why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to focus on forgiveness. When you get closer to Allah, you know what's exactly your value. You understand that you have been missing a lot. You understand that you have been in shortcoming even if you are in the masjid 24/7. And that is the reason the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he spent the whole night praying, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already forgiven all of his sins. And Aisha is telling him, Ya Rasulullah, why you are giving yourself that hard time? Your foot has swelled. And Allah already has forgiven all of your sins. And he said, Ya Aisha, shouldn't I be a thankful, grateful servant to Allah? And he said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, No one is gonna make it to Jannah because of his deeds, apparent deeds. They said, even you, Ya Rasulullah. He said, even me. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will overshadow me with His mercy. With His mercy. So the time you get closer to Allah, you will understand that you are always in shortcoming status. So you will be always in a need for Allah's forgiveness and pardoning. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will submit the decision of forgiveness, it's gone. You will never be hurt either in dunya or in the hereafter. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. To end inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala the second khutbah, I'll leave two ahadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The night of power is great. Ramadan is great. The acts of worship are great. But without getting closer to Allah and having fruits of these acts of worship, there is no value. There is no value. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has left that meaning in the hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, and it's reported in by Ibn Hibban and Ibn Hakim, and Sheikh al-Albani has synthesized, he has confirmed the authenticity of both of them. What's better than the deeds in the night of power? Abu Huraira said, they were one day in one of the battles by the shoreline, and those guys, the guardians, they are in a night shift protecting the camps of Muslims, and so all of them left to change the shift, and Abu Huraira stayed in his place. And he said, Ya Abu Huraira, why you didn't leave with us? And he repeated, he said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, for a Muslim, a brother, a believer, to stand in his place, taking care of his deen, that can be orphanage, that can be donation, that can be even business, that can be work, taking care of family, taking care of parents, kissing the hand of parents, under the foot of parents, taking care of your kids' deen, taking care of protecting the borders of the Ummah of Muhammad, whatever the action is. He said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that a person protecting, staying the night protecting a border from the borders of Muslim, khayrun inda Allahi min qiyam laylatil qadr inda al-hajar al-aswad. It's better in the eye of Allah than praying the night of power accepted in front of the black stone in Mecca. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanna tell us, you have been given too many great things. When you receive this post in the last few days, look for the night of power in your damir, in your inside, not in the masajid. No, I wanna correct that meaning. I wanna you to look for the night of power in your damir, in your inside, along with your acts of worship. Because your acts of worship are the means and the tools and the keys that will take you closer to Allah. Because that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught the ummah of Muhammad, how we can get closer to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our heart with His love and the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us to the right path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who are going to be able to leave the month of Ramadan. Insha'Allah accepted. Insha'Allah accepted. Insha'Allah accepted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept their fasting, their prayer, all of the righteous deeds, make it sincere to His cause.